Well, Ben and Jen, a number of people on Lamont's administration are now self-isolating after his spokesperson tested positive for COVID-19 last week. But here, the governor held his conference, not here at the state capitol as usual, but over video back at his home in Greenwich.
COVID cases ramping up in Connecticut. Since Friday, 4,369 new cases and 98 new hospitalizations.
It's not a matter of a lockdown. It's not a matter of a shutdown. It's a matter of a tailored response.
The governor pushed back into phase two this month, requiring many businesses, such as indoor dining, to close by 9:30. But with the continued rise in cases, he's now considering additional restrictions.
We're going to be looking at gyms. We're going to be looking at indoor dining. We'll be looking at churches, if we have to, going forward.
Another major cause of concern, thousands of students heading back home for Thanksgiving break. The governor asking students, especially from schools under quarantine, such as UConn, to self-isolate for 14 days and get tested.
We can't enforce this. I'm going to have to depend upon your good judgment to make sure, and your parents' good judgment, your family's good judgment, that you follow the protocols, you follow the quarantine, and you follow the testing.
Joining Monday's briefing, Yale professor Dr. Marcella Nunez-Smith. She was on Connecticut's reopening task force and has been named a co-chair of President-elect Joe Biden's COVID-19 task force.
The board is thinking about how we optimize equity and efficiency across all of these areas. So whether that be in testing, in contact tracing, providing supports as needed, such as food or housing during quarantine and isolation, in access to the treatments we see coming on board, and of course in vaccine distribution.
And while Lamont did touch on biotech company Moderna's announcement regarding a nearly 95% effective COVID vaccine, he says what matters today is safety protocols until vaccines are widely available.
This is going to take months. So that's why what we can do to bend the curve now is the bridge to the vaccine that will make an enormous, enormous difference.
The governor has also asked President Trump to extend support from the Connecticut National Guard until June of next year. That support is set to expire at the end of December. We're live in Hartford tonight. Zinia Maldonado, Fox 61 News.